Hey everybody, Friendly Neighborhood Snowman here. Welcome back to Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. Last time we didn't get too far. We got basic exposition done. A lot more mystery showed up than answers. Then again, it is episode one. So, we're gonna go right back into it. I'm recording it basically right after where I left off. Only about an hour or so. So if there's any comments or anything, I have yet to see them.
You know, they see me as an outsider here as well.
But also, I had to do a little bit of walking around when I first came into this because it didn't autosave exactly where I was. So we're just gonna jump right in, explore a little bit more of this area, and see what we can find.
It's not just about faith. It's about the community.
Ooh. Gate.
Seen as
locked.
Part of it.
Damn. Should have figured.
Mrs. Appleton, isn't it?
It's Dr. Collins.
Back road. Let's see what this leads to. Alright. Controller vibrated and I wasn't sure exactly why. Yeah. So, I mean, I really don't know what to think about what's going on. I really wish I could take one of these radios with me in case anything changes, or even that telephone from earlier. Wow. I don't think I have to explore all of these. I really hope I don't have to explore all of these. That would take too much time and be boring as hell. Luckily, it doesn't look like a very large town. Okay, I'm just gonna take a look at the doors, and if I see one cracked open, I'll... The hell is that? Graffiti? No, can't open it. Well, damn. That's luck, too. We're obviously somewhere in Europe. I don't know where, but we're definitely somewhere in Europe because the whole 50p thing. Flu is highly contagious. Do not attempt to travel. Is it? I don't really think it was the flu. Oh, more bloody tissues. We're coughing up blood. Wow, a lot of people were.
Dr. Wade, here you are. Well, there's a queue of patients a mile long out there.
Just send them to the village hall with the others, please, Bob.
Doctor, people are scared. Mrs. Gables just called me and said her husband's vanished. She was very frightened. She said there was blood coming up from his ears and his
what
nose.
What the hell do you want me to do? Until they lift the quarantine, we're not going anywhere. Just tell them to drink plenty of fluids, stay warm, and follow the instructions on the radio.
Dr. Phil, please, you have a duty to your patient. Your nose.
Nothing different? Nope. Nothing different. What is that code? 1614157 whatever. It's odd. This whole thing is odd, to be quite honest. It's really intriguing though. I mean, I'm just not sure what to do or where to go. I mean, so far, that is probably the most accurate part of the whole situation. Because, realistically, not many of us would know where we would be going or what we would be doing. Not very many of us would have an idea of what to do if we were the last people around. I mean, not even if we were the last people around, but if we were, if we just found ourselves in a situation where we had to, oh, look at that, I'm gonna go look at that, where we had to fend for ourselves. Survival is not easy. Whoever was doing this is really good. Couldn't open that. Really wish there was a way to move a little bit faster than just, Hey! Really wish something would tell me where I'm supposed to be going. Whoa, what? Whoa! Okay, maybe this is where I have to be going. I don't...
Whoa. I saw you from the main road. Not many people are moving around now.
I was looking for Dr. Wade.
Listen, Frank. I don't know what's happened, but your Steven seems to think he's responsible.
I reckon he is.
He said, Kate's still up at the observatory, but the gates are locked. And Frank, there's gonna be a rescue soon, I'm sure of it. They'll send planes or something.
Well, they'll send planes, all right. This pattern of his, we're in the center of it. Which means if they intend to stop it, we're right in the firing line.
True. That's a lot more than I've seen anywhere else. Huh. How could one person be the cause of something like this? There's a frisbee on top of that. It just... I'm gonna have to find out, because I don't really see how one person could be the cause of anything like this. This is large scale.
Meg, come and have a look at this.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Charlie?
Jeremy reckons someone had been raiding all the empty houses. He said a load of stuff had been taken.
What's up?
It looks like someone's been collecting their own supplies.
Bastard!
Well, we've got enough stock in the warehouse to keep the entire village going for months.
We should get a truck.
What, and go and get all of it now?
Yeah, why not?
It's Appleton. It's that bloody crackpot Stephen Appleton. I'm gonna fucking do him.
Sam, it's fine. We better get moving before the weather turns. You come in. We'll swing by the camp and get Rachel on the way back.
I'm sorry, I just realized how stupid something I said earlier was. Of course we're in Europe. Listen to their accents. Duh. That was dumb. Okay, so Stephen is the same Stephen Appleton from the observatory. Which is up there, I think. Or is that the church? That's a church. It is a game called Everybody's Gone to the Rapture, so why don't we go to the church? Find out.
If you could just have a word with them, perhaps. Now they listen to you.
Well, I really don't see what it has to do with me at all.
The village looks up to you. I just think with what's been happening with Mr. Coles and and Mrs. Boughton and the others, that people need somewhere to talk, to feel safe.
Perhaps they don't think that your church is somewhere they feel particularly safe.
I don't need your forgiveness, Wendy, or theirs. Whosoever thou art that judgest, for wherein thou judgest another, thou condemnest thyself. Romans chapter 2, verse 1.
Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people in order to be seen by them. Matthew chapter 6, verse 1.
Ooh.
It's not my judgment you should be worried about, Father. But fine. I'll talk to Barbara. Ask her to put a note up in the surgery about an extra service. Will that do?
Throwing scripture right back at him. But the reason I was quiet is because I was thinking for a second.
Well, loaves and fishes we can manage,
Father,
but garden
Jeremy,
design is a little beyond.
Might I have a word?
Mrs. Boyles, of course. Meg, will you excuse us, please?
See you back at Charlie's later. Cheerio,
I was trying to talk. Sure.
I was speaking to Barbara. She said there were some irregularities about Mary's morphine.
Good grief. I mean, those are private medical records. Barbara should know better than to be discussing that sort of thing with you. If Dr. Wade finds out, he'll have no choice but to suspend her. Damn it, Wendy! Your brother is grieving. Mary was sick for a long time, and I'm glad it's over for her. Go and support Frank. He needs you now.
God knows what you did. He sees. I just pray he can overlook Mary's weakness, but you, a man of the cloth,
if you have an issue
you
with...
bring shame on this parish.
If you have an issue with me, I suggest you write to the Bishop of the Diocese. I have parishioners to attend to. Excuse me.
What did he do? That's what I was trying to figure out. What did he do? What could he have done to cause such turmoil? I hate gardening. I can't do it. Church shouldn't be locked. Candles. The candles have the same effect as the swirly, spinny stuff is weird. I bet you're wondering why I've got you here, gathered you all here today. Nice to see that everybody shows up. Just a quick question. The fuck is going on? Sorry, I couldn't help myself. Okay. So, but this is really weird. Like, there's nothing I can do. There's no buttons I can press. And this seems like a place that I should be. Odd. I feel like I'm missing something in there. I don't know, but there was the same kind of leftover energy effect as in the kids' room. I don't know. There's so many questions to answer. It's fascinating. If you hit the button twice, you close the door, apparently. Why would you ever close a door in the Rapture? Unless it's to your own shelter. I mean, I don't even... Why would you care? Hey, you! Where am I going? Show me where I'm going! I wonder if they actually show me where I'm going, or if they're just flying around. Oh, is this a hospital of some kind?
What about the station?
That's shut down too. So there's no way in or out of the valley. They're obviously serious about this flu thing.
Phil doesn't think it's flu at all. He said he's been practicing medicine for 30 years and he's seen plenty of flu, and he said this doesn't feel right at all.
Well, there's nothing of any use on the radio.
Sorry I'm late, everyone. Have you started?
Yes, but to be honest, there's not really that much to discuss. This quarantine is in place. There's roadblocks and everything. No one really seems to know anything, but people are definitely missing. More of them too, not just a couple of old biddies. No one's seen the Sullivans since yesterday, and the house is just sitting there unlocked.
I just got back from the farm. All of Frank's cows died in the night. He's devastated.
Poor man. Hasn't he had enough for 1 year? First Mary and now this.
Well, if no one's coming in to sort this mess out, we're just going to have to do it ourselves. Barbara, get Phil to do a stock take on medication. Jeremy, put the word out for people to congregate at the village hall. It's best we get everyone in one place for the time being.
Good.
I'll organize supplies. We'll have a lot of hungry mouths to feed. There's plenty at the depot, but well, let's start with what's here in the village. I'll draw up a rota. Charlie, you help me with that?
Anything for you, Meg.
I'll head out into the valley and scoop up the isolated families and check in with Lizzie Graves at the camp. Has anyone seen or heard anything from Stephen Appleton or his wife?
I'll take that as a no. Okay, so all of this seems to be pointing back to the observatory. Any of these doors open? Oh, you do. Is there anything in here? Oh. That scared me. Monkey bars! Those were so much fun as a kid. Can I go through here? To get back to the... I don't think I can. I think I just went in a circle. Damn it. So... Where is that thing going? Oh, where did it go? Over the bridge. Oh, okay. It's showing me that there's something on the bridge that I need to see, I think. Such a beautiful environment. I didn't know I could go in the water. Come on, go around the thing. There we go. Why? What's going on? Why can't I do the thing? Hello? Oh. Whoa.
Is everything all right?
Get out of my way.
Where's Kate?
Where do you think she is?
Stephen, what's going on?
Screw Kate. It's all her fault anyway.
What's that mark on your face? Stephen! Stephen!
Did you hear somebody cough? That's the same thing as when I went. I am totally confused. Okay, so Steven is saying that it's Kate's fault. Okay, I'm back to the pub now. I think I walked all the way around. So there's the church up there. I don't think I went to these buildings. Where does that go? Where's that one headed? Isn't that... There's a fire in that house. The chimney is going. I don't think I was in that one. The stars at night. See, I don't know, now I'm confused because I thought I went down here. Isn't that... I did go down here. I don't think I got into that house though. How do I get in there? Cause now that's important now. Come on. Wait a minute. I didn't do this before, I don't think. Carphone? Carphone.
Visual and auditory distortions are becoming more frequent, along with mild convulsions to the left side, all of which support a preliminary diagnosis of intracranial hypertension, occurring as a result of a substantial and rapidly expanding tumor, originating, I believe, within the hypothalamus. Cognitive functions are currently unimpaired. Aside from this crippling headache, hemorrhaging is becoming more frequent, with darker clots passing through the nasal passages primarily. I believe I am dying. This is certainly not flu. Anything else I have ever encountered. And certainly, a tumor cannot expand this rapidly. In the blood clots, I see tiny flecks of what looks almost like, if I had to try and find a description, liquid light.
What?
I cannot explain this phenomenon.
Liquid light. I have absolutely no idea what that means. Liquid light. I didn't go over here before. Okay. I get it. Go this way. I think. I have no idea what they mean.
You have to make a decision, Lizzie.
Oh.
Especially now.
But I do love him, Father. I love them both.
He's married. There are other people involved in this.
Oh, I hardly think that anyone's in the position to claim the moral high ground, do you?
Well, I take your point about Stephen and Robert, but I think Kate might see things differently.
Do you? I mean, she's not screwing anyone else, pardon my French, but she spends all day and night locked up in that observatory. Stephen says they barely see each other. That's hardly a marriage, is it?
Oh, okay. That explains why Kate was pissed off at Jeremy, or Stephen. Stephen, yeah, that explains why she was mad at Stephen. Doesn't explain. It still doesn't explain what the priest did. I gotta go back this way and see if I can get into that blue house, because that might be something. Can't get in. I don't understand. I have been here. I remember being in the... Okay. Then what's so important about the blue house? It's that little ball of light trying to troll me. I'm not entirely sure where to go from here. I think I've been pretty much everywhere in this little town. I don't understand where I'm supposed to go or what I'm supposed to do. Let's head back up to the church, and from the church, we'll try and do the little twisty controller thing. Why? What is it? I know they tell me to go to somewhere of importance. Well, I think. But I've been there. And it would be really helpful if I could move a little faster. It is kind of nice that things are so peaceful, though. Oh, yeah, I had to go around. Wait, where did I go? I can go through the Oh, yeah, I think I had one up here. Yep, door's open. I've been here. Door's open. Okay, can't open those doors. I seem to be moving a little slower. Twisting the controller, nothing's happening. I just don't know. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave this episode here regardless. So, let's see what happens. Alright, thank you everybody for watching, and leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe. I don't know where to go from here. I'm probably going to wander around on my own without recording and see where I'm supposed to go, and when something happens, I'll start the recording back up. I don't know, but thank you everybody for watching. And stay frosty, my friends.